Ever feel more at home in your cubicle than your own living room? You're not alone. We're told work-life balance is key. But what if life is the part that's out of whack? Sometimes the predictability of work is comforting. You clock in, you clock out, you do your tasks, no emotional baggage, messy breakups or existential crises. Unless you work at a startup, then all bets are off. Don't get me wrong, I'm not advocating for becoming a workaholic, but there's something to be said for the simplicity and structure of the workplace. It's like a sitcom with better lighting and less laugh track. Ever wake up from a fantastic dream and feel cheated by reality? That's what I call a nightmare in reverse. It's like the universe is playing a cruel joke. You're on a tropical beach with a bottomless margarita, then bam, back to your alarm clock and lukewarm coffee. It makes you wonder, what if we've got it all wrong? What if dreams are the real world and this whole being alive thing is just a temporary blip on the radar of our subconscious? Maybe this explains our fascination with simulations and virtual reality. We're all just trying to get back to that blissful state of dreaming. Life is short. It's better to have loved and lost than never to have loved at all. These sayings are like fortune cookies baked by a committee of well-meaning but slightly delusional optimists. Look, I'm all for a positive outlook, but sometimes these platitudes feel like we're trying to convince ourselves that life's inherent shittiness is somehow charming. Life be short. And heartbreak? It freaking sucks. Can we at least be honest about that? Remember the magic of believing. Santa Claus, the Tooth Fairy, the Easter Bunny, all delivering joy and wonder, and questionable dental hygiene habits in the Tooth Fairy's case. Then, bam, your parents, those well-meaning agents of reality, rip the band-aid off and reveal the truth. It's like finding out pro wrestling is fake. The world feels a little less magical, a little less fun. But here's the thing, that disillusionment is a necessary part of growing up. It's about learning to find wonder and magic in the real world, even if it means accepting that sometimes a cigar is just a cigar. Grocery shopping, laundry, paying bills. These are the thrilling activities that fill our days. We dream of adventure and excitement, yet we spend a good chunk of our lives in a state of mundane autopilot. But here's the thing, maybe we're missing the point. There's a certain poetry to the mundane, a quiet satisfaction in completing a task, no matter how small. The next time you find yourself cursing the self-checkout line, take a breath. Look around, appreciate the absurd normalcy of it all. It's these little moments strung together that make up the tapestry of our lives. Let's talk about work. We trade our precious time, our very life force, for currency. It's a raw deal when you think about it. We're essentially selling chunks of our finite existence to buy things we don't need to impress people we don't like. And yet, we keep clocking in. Why? Because we crave purpose. We need to feel like our time here means something. We want to contribute, to create, to build something larger than ourselves. The trick is finding work that aligns with our values, that doesn't feel like we're slowly dying inside with each passing spreadsheet. Easier said than done, I know. We humans are funny creatures. We crave structure and routine, yet we long for spontaneity and adventure. We build systems and hierarchies, then rail against the very confines we've created. We're constantly searching for meaning, for purpose, often in all the wrong places. We buy things we don't need, chase after fleeting pleasures, and scroll through endless feeds of curated perfection, all the while feeling empty inside. Maybe the answer isn't about finding meaning, but about creating it, about embracing the chaos and finding beauty in the mundane, about recognizing that life isn't about finding all the answers, but about learning to ask better questions. Ever notice how the customer service rep is always having a worse day than you are? It's like they're contractually obligated to be miserable, and who can blame them? They deal with the dregs of humanity on a daily basis. But here's the thing, good customer service can make or break a business. A smile, a kind word, a willingness to go the extra mile. It can make all the difference. It's a reminder that even in the most mundane interactions, we have the power to brighten someone's day, or at least not make it any worse. And sometimes that's enough. So how do we navigate this messy, chaotic, often contradictory thing called life? There's no easy answer, no magic formula, but here are a few things I've learned along the way. Embrace the suck. Life is full of challenges and disappointments. Don't try to sugarcoat it. Acknowledge the suck, feel your feelings, then pick yourself up and keep going. Find your people, surround yourself with people who get you, who challenge you, who make you laugh until your sides hurt. Life is too short, I said it, to waste time on people who drain your energy. Don't take yourself too seriously. We're all just bumbling through this thing called life. Laugh at your mistakes, embrace your flaws, and remember it's okay to not have all the answers. The truth is, most of life is pretty ordinary, but that doesn't mean it has to be boring. The key is to find the extraordinary in the everyday moments. Savor that first cup of coffee in the morning. Listen to your favorite song like it's the first time. Tell your loved ones how much they mean to you. Find joy in the simple things, because those are the moments that truly matter. Life isn't about waiting for the big moments. It's about embracing the small ones. It's about finding beauty in the mundane, magic in the chaos, and meaning in the midst of it all. This is where the rubber meets the road, folks. The key to navigating life's ups and downs is to stop giving AAF asterisk CSK about the things that don't truly matter. Stop chasing after other people's definitions of success. Stop comparing yourself to others. Stop worrying about what other people think. Focus your energy on the things that bring you joy, that light you up from the inside out. Spend time with the people who make you feel alive. Pursue your passions, even if they scare the hell out of you. Life is too short. Okay, I'll stop now to waste time on things that don't make you feel truly alive. So go out there and live your damn life. Leave a comment, like and subscribe to Rodney's Publishing, or click the link in my bio to leave room for Human Errors 13 short stories.